or two. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. How's everybody doing tonight? Somebody say yes. Let me hear you say yeah. We have a star-studded show this evening. We got one of my good friends, icon, a pioneer in the music business, Mr. Jackie Santo, plays with the Beaver Brown Band. Give it up, y'all. And the Tavares is here tonight. My good friend, oh yeah. I see a lot of good friends out there. We have a star-studded show. We got some great talent tonight. Superstar, the greatest show on the planet here tonight. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, how you feel? Somebody say, yeah. Uncle Bruce in the house. I see everybody in the house tonight. Without further ado, we bring to you the star-studded show, ladies and gentlemen. Put your hands together for my friend, your friend, everybody's friend, Mr. Paul Santos.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the show. Is everybody in a good mood tonight? Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Hi, yes, welcome to the Paul Santos Live Show. Oh, and how about that introduction from the co-host with cachet, the co-host with class, the co-host with cojones. Say hello to Mr. Chops Turner, there he is.
Choppy!
And how about talent with a capital T? We're so glad to have these gentlemen on board. It is Gary Langevin, Artie DeMello, and the Paul Santos Live Band. Here they are. And thanks to you for the people that are coming out here tonight. 10% off dinner for everybody that's here watching the show tonight. So thank you very much for coming on down. Special shout out to those watching on Channel 6 in Providence, those watching on Channel 95 in the New Bedford area. And if you're watching live tonight on Facebook or on YouTube, type a comment in. Say hello. We want to know that you're there. Right, Chops? We want to know that you're there. So say hello, and we'll give a shout-out right back. What a lineup of guests we have tonight. We're going to tell you all about that in just a moment. But first, let's get caught up in the news. How about that?
This is my source of news for the week.
Hey, you know, I really don't want to make a big deal out of it or anything, but you know what today is, Chops? Today's my birthday! Yeah. Oh, God. Hey, another year older, I'm telling you. I got to tell you. You know, as I get older, these weird things start happening. You know, my body's changing and everything, you know?
Every week.
My feet, they keep getting bigger. Did you know that? My feet keep getting bigger. I used to take a size 8.5 shoe. Then it went to a 9. Oh, then it went to a 9.5. Now I take a 10 wide. I'm even gaining girth. Can you imagine that? So I said to my doctor, I said, does this happen all over the body? He says, yeah, your ears are getting bigger.
This is sad. Happy birthday, Paul.
You think my ears are getting bigger?
Yeah, definitely. No, your head's getting bigger. Your ears are staying the same.
Oh! Well, anyway, I got to tell you, you know, here's something that really happens, right? Sometimes when I go into a store, I leave my prescription sunglasses on, right? Now, it's fine if I'm walking around with my wife, but if we separate and I walk around by myself, people start getting creeped out. I'm serious. I walk around like this, you know, walking down an aisle. Wow. Especially if it's a woman's store, they're kind of like...
In the lingerie department.
What is this? It's kind of like, you know, I'm getting a little creeped out with this guy, right? So the other day, the same thing happened at the store. So I went back to my wife and I said, honey, you know, I'm really not going to wear these prescription sunglasses anymore. I think people are getting creeped out. My wife said, hey, maybe it's not the sunglasses.
You can count on it.
That's right. There she is. Ann Santos here tonight. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here on my birthday. I really appreciate it. We have a lot of laughs, that's for sure, and hopefully we'll have a few tonight. We definitely have a lot of talent in the building, so that's for sure. Hey, you know, here's something that's in the news. The great Aretha Franklin passed away recently, and there was a battle over her will. Imagine that. She actually cut out some of her important family members, and they sued, and they went to court, and they went in front of the judge, and the family members said, Your Honor, is it true that Aretha Franklin cut us family members out of the will? So the judge stood up, and the judge said, Chain, 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 you chain of fools.
I thought you were going to be like, you need to show me a little more. R-E-S-B-U-T.
Come on, Gary, help me out here. Help me out a little bit here. Help me out. It's my birthday, for God's sake.
I know. I'm going to show you. I'm giving you reality for your birthday, brother, okay?
Hey, you know, I graduated New Bedford High School. Hey, New Bedford High School graduates here tonight. All right, I see Adam over there. Adam, New Bedford High, class of 93, right? Yeah, we was on that Boston Garden court. And New Bedford High School won the state championship. I'll tell you, that was great. Well, you know, I ran into one of these, like, big shots of the class, one of these valedictorians. And, you know, sometimes they get a little carried away being intellectuals and everything.
Oh, yeah, I can't stand those people, Paul.
So he comes up to me and goes, oh, Paul Santos, yes, I hear you on the radio. I see you have a television show. I see that you're an attorney and a Juris Doctor degree. I'm just wondering if you have any art. I said, yeah, I have rheumatoid arthritis. Yeah. That's about it.
Yeah, he's playing the saxophone. Hey.
Hey, Jackie, wake up over there, Jackie. Wake up over there.
No, he's like a possum. Playing dead. Leave him alone.
For the price you paid to get in here, that's damn good stuff, I'll tell you right now.
He doesn't want you calling him up. I think that's the thing, right?
Hey, you know, Britney Spears is in the news. You know, she's on Broadway with a brand new musical called Once Upon a One More Time. Imagine that. So a friend of mine saw it. So I said to my friend, I said, you saw it, huh? Was it any good? He goes, well, let's put it this way. I spent all night Les Miserables.
Yeah. For the theater fans out there, that was hilarious. For everybody else.
Hey, we have any parrot heads here? Any Jimmy Buffett fans?
Boo.
Jimmy Buffett made a surprise appearance in Portsmouth, Massachusetts at a place called Sunset Cove. Portsmouth, Rhode Island.
Jeez, get your geography. You got a doctrine, sparitis, whatever. And, you don't
and the cue what... card says Portsmouth, Rhode Island, too. Now, he showed up at Portsmouth, Rhode Island at a place called Sunset Cove and just started playing. And everybody was so excited they couldn't believe he was there. He did his great song, Margaritaville. Well, I'm thinking to myself, maybe he should have gone over to New Bedford and sang for one of my relatives, you know? I mean, there's a few margaritas over there. Margarita Silva.
Oh, hey.
Margarita Santos. I mean, it's a regular Margaritaville, you know what I'm saying? I even got table number three that time. I was watching table number three. Well, I'm sorry to bring this news to you already, Chops. Time goes by so quickly when you're having a great time. Time just goes by quickly. What happened? I am now going to bring to you the final joke of the night.
The final joke.
You got to give yourself a hernia if this keeps up. I'll tell you right now.
I mean another one.
Every week he goes up another octave. You know, we're doing the show from Massachusetts, not that far from Cape Cod. Well, you know, there's an exhibit in Chatham, Massachusetts, right? And down there at this exhibit, there was a model of the actual shark that was used in the movie Jaws. How many fans of the movie Jaws? Isn't that a great movie? Yeah, that's right. Very good, Artie. Very good. Well, anyway, the model is there. The model of the movie Jaws, the shark in Jaws. Hey, wait a minute. This reminds me of something. This reminds me of one of Gary's exes, Jenny Jaws.
Oh, yes, that's right. She was a real...
She had a big mouth, I'll tell you that.
A hell of an overbite, I'll tell you that.
In fact, she was a cop. She was really tough. She took a bite out of more than crime, I'll tell you that. A final joke.
Oh, that's it?
I'm sorry.
Wait. No.
No, that's all I have tonight. I'm sorry.
No. Well, you just let me know. I'm going to make five more, but now, okay.
A final joke.
All right. Well, we have a great show for you tonight. What a lineup of guests. In the house tonight is a great singer by the name of Kyla J is here tonight. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
We also have Boston's queen of the blues and soul, Miss Toni Lynn Washington, is in the house from Boston. We have legendary Boston DJ, Mr. Skippy White, is here tonight. Hailing out of Fall River, Massachusetts, comic Sam Pelletier. The host of a brand new show called Dying for Laughs, our own in-house comic, Allison Dyan, is here tonight.
Allie, Oxen.
And you know something? I think we may just have time for Crazy Casey tonight. I don't know.
Yeah, Big Daddy O.
We're going to try to squeeze him in. If the shoe fits, I...
Hey!
We'd like to thank our sponsors, the place that the show is coming from tonight, Mikey B's, Mikey B's Shops.
Yeah, home sweet home.
We'd like to thank also J&J Materials, Aaron Pools and Spas, Attorney John Seed, Tomatoes Italian Grill, Alden Court, Cisco New Bedford, and Bristol County Media, our good friend Aaron Cashew. Thank you for being a supporter of our show. All right, stand by. We start with comedy in just a moment. But first, say hello to Gary and Artie. It's the PSL Band. We'll be right back. Maria Pereira says, happy birthday, Paul. Sorry about the reception on the Aretha Franklin joke. And then Maria said, hey, I went to Volk Tech. What's the matter with Volk Tech? Anybody here from Volk Tech? No, just the Bedford High School? Thanks, Chops. We got one clap in the audience. Okay. All right, thanks to Gary and Artie and the PSL Band. Let's hear it for those guys.
Thank you very much, both of you.
All right, our first guest tonight is a comic. He's originally from Maine. He spent some time in Boston, Massachusetts, and now he lives in Fall River, Massachusetts, not that far away. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for a great comic, Mr. Sam Pelletier.
Yeah.
Hey.
You know, I begged Paul not to say the Fall River thing in the introduction.
Move to your left. There you go.
Yankees fan communist next time, please. Happy to be here. I only have this look on my face because I recently agreed to take an old job back. That's not fun, but it's better for me than job interviews. Can't stand those. One time I actually said this. I said, how come I have to make a resume and then I have to fill out an application with the same information as on the resume? Dude looked me right in the face. Said, listen, if you cannot do pointless repetitive tasks over and over again, there is no place for you at this Dunkin' Donuts. We are repetitive here at the Dunkin'. We have called the same cop on the same guy sitting in the same parking space twice in the last month. And he is interviewing right after you, so we gotta wrap this up. So money-wise, not doing great, but I am enjoying another part of life. I have really started to enjoy dating as a millennial guy ever since I realized my competition was other millennial guys. Girls look at me like a sign for Denny's at 4 a.m. It's not good, but it's available. Like, guys, remember when you thought you had to accomplish something to get the ladies? Like, I gotta get a six-pack and learn to play the guitar, and I gotta go to law school and have a public access show and all that, right? In 2023, to get female attention, you know what I have to have? Not felonies. Absolutely it. And if anyone in the crowd, if you're dating a guy in his early, mid-30s, dump him. Immediately. Get yourself a 22-year-old guy. That's what you need. And I always get weird stares for that. But and it's not just the physical endurance, which is pretty awesome. The reason is, that guy was born in the year 2001, meaning that guy has no hang-ups. That guy has no inner turmoil, because that guy has been in therapy since he was 4 years old. Millennials, they, like, kids who are 20 now, they're actually sensitive people. My generation is halfway sensitive. Like, when I was growing up, they told me to be sensitive. They just didn't tell any of the other kids to be sensitive. Just walk back to the teacher like, hey, Ms. Donaldson, are you sure that hands are not for hitting? Because Billy's hands, fantastic at hitting. Oh, we're halfway sensitive, and that's why I truly believe millennials, at least the guys, we are the worst people. Because if you're in this room and you're over 40, you're hardworking, resilient, you're tough. If you're under 25, that one table back there, if you're under 25, you're sensitive, you're empathetic, you're a good friend. Millennials, we're just standing in no man's land watching anime in our pajamas. It's not a good place to be. And that's why we're canceling everybody. We love cancel culture in here, right? I really confused your audience, and I'm sorry. It truly bugs me to hear regular people complain about cancel culture. I mean, like, Facebook reunion group type friends. Because here's the thing. If you are a millionaire actor, celebrity, politician, and everyone's telling you to shut up, it might be cancel culture. But if you manage a Staples, everyone tells you, you might be an idiot, and that might be why. And it has nothing to do with society or politics. We all have a friend who just says the wrong thing at the wrong time. I don't believe in monogamy. I just plain don't believe in monogamy. Dude, this is my sister's wedding. She doesn't believe in it either. Don't worry about that. I'm gonna get out of here, but I want to leave you all on an optimistic note, because whatever my soapbox is or your soapbox is, we all have to come together, and that means compromise. What kind of compromise? I'm so glad you asked. We're gonna do drag queen story hour.
Yes.
But it's Amish drag queens. Full beard. All the stories are about farming. Everyone gets a gun. Except the police. Every candidate for office must appear at least twice on America's Got Talent.
There you go. That's right.
Hey, my name's Sam Pelletier. Thank you all so much.
Great stuff, Sam. Stay right there. Sam Pelletier, ladies and gentlemen. All right, so a little background about Sam over here. Sam originally from Maine, then Boston, but how did you end up in Fall River?
Fall River is the best place in the world to find a wife. Not married yet, but we're working on it.
So what part of Fall River are you living in now?
I want to say the northern hilly part where some of the people actually own the houses, that part. Does that make sense?
That's my favorite right, so, part is the Highlands.
Highlands, lowland. So how long have you been involved in comedy?
Give or take 10 years, took some breaks here and there. Started in Maine, where there was fierce competition. There's a lot of people in Maine trying to be professional stand-up comedians. I was in Boston before the pandemic, and then the pandemic happened, and I said, why am I paying so much to live in Boston? So I moved around a little, and I found my way to the South Shore. It's a very successful path that I'm on, I think.
Well, we really appreciate you stopping by our show tonight. I saw you the other night at an open mic. I thought you were one of the top comics there. And I know we grabbed you kind of on short notice, and you were very courteous to stop on by. Really appreciate that. Funny stuff.
Thank you so much, Paul.
Sam Bellatier, we'll be right back with more of the Paul Santos Live Show. Stay where you are.
Helpless as a kitten up a tree. I feel like I'm clinging to a cloud. I can't understand. I get misty just holding your hand. Walk my way, and a thousand violins begin to play. Or it might be the sound of your hello. That music I hear. I get misty moment you're near. You can say that you're leading me on, but it's just what I want you to do. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? That's why I'm following you. Oh, on my own.
All right, shout out to Craig Brightman watching tonight. Thank you very much. Stella Rich is looking in. Thank you so much. And Philip McDonald, thank you very much for looking in tonight. Derek Pinyankos is also watching tonight. So that's always great. It's always fun to have folks watching. All right. All right. Well, I'm going to put this microphone stand right over here. That way our next performer will be ready to go. She's a terrific singer. She's been on our show before, and what we really like about her is not only is she talented, not only is she performing in music, but she's had some obstacles to overcome, and we're going to talk a little bit about that. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Kyla J?
let me
say hello first. How are you?
I'm good.
Great to see you.
Great to see you as well.
All right, here comes the equipment. Here comes the guitar, and it will be good to go. Here we go.
Yeah. All right.
All right, so this is a song that you all know, so if you would like to sing along or clap along, feel free. This one's called The Middle. Hey, don't write yourself off yet. It's only in your head you feel left out. Look down on. Just try your best. Try everything you can. And don't you worry what they tell themselves when you're away. It just takes some. sometime. Little girl, you're in the middle of the ride. Everything, everything'll be just fine. Everything, everything'll be alright, alright. Hey, you know they're all the same. You know you're doing better on your own. So don't buy it. Live right now and just be yourself. It doesn't matter if it's good enough for someone else. Come on! It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in the middle of the ride. Everything, everything'll be just fine. Everything, everything'll be alright, alright. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in the middle of the ride. Everything, everything'll be just fine. Everything, everything'll be alright, alright. Keep on clapping! Love it! Don't write yourself off yet. It's only in your head you feel left out or looked down on. Just do your best. Do everything you can. It doesn't matter what the bitter hearts are gonna say. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in the middle of the ride. Everything, everything'll be just fine. Everything, everything'll be alright, alright. It just takes some time. Little girl, you're in the middle of the ride. Everything, everything'll be just fine. Everything, everything'll be alright, alright.
Oh, that was awesome, Kyla J. Oh man, that was an awesome job. We're gonna tilt this camera up just a little bit so we can have a quick chat with Kyla. Hey, that was a great job. It's a real good sing along, and I know it was one of those songs that you had mentioned before you came on. You were like, "Hey, I want to do something that's gonna get the crowd going," and you definitely picked the perfect song.
Yes, it's one of my favorite songs because the lyrics are so uplifting and. They are very motivational, and they have honestly helped me a lot when I need some good vibes. And I think that it is important for good vibes to be spread. But hey, before we continue this interview, I said I had a surprise for you. Can we all give Paul Santos a little happy birthday song? Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Paul. Happy birthday to you.
Oh, thank you so much. Hey Chop, you see the present I got over here? I got a little sash now. Can you believe this? I got my own sash. I've never seen that before. I never got one of those before. What do you think about the sash?
I think the sash is pretty great. You know, it fits perfect and it matches perfectly with your outfit. And I think, you know, makes a great show statement.
Here he is, Mr. My Birthday Day. Here he is, walking down the aisle.
So you like it, Gary, huh?
I love it. I love it.
All right, sounds good. Well, I want to talk to you real quickly about what's going on with you, because since the last time I talked to you, I noticed you're singing a lot more, you have a lot more gigs. You're really taking your music to the next stage, I would say, next step.
Well, ever since last year, I went to L.A., I did some training out there, I performed for some people who could advanced me in the industry, got a call back from one of them, and learned a lot of what I wanted for myself going forward and what I didn't want. And I just thought to myself, you know, I don't think the industry is, you know, my place yet, because I just want to be doing what I love, because I want to be having fun because, you know, you have to protect the place where the music comes from, and it should be fun because you know what I say?
That's right.
If you aren't having fun, what are you doing? Just go do something else.
That's right. Right. Exactly. 100%. Now, real quick, I know you have a visual impairment. We talked a little bit about it last time. And the only reason why I bring that up is because I really love seeing people overcome their obstacles. And you've been able to do that.
Well, when I was younger, I was diagnosed with optic nerve hypoplasia. And the eye doctor told me that I would probably never be able to see about maybe 15 inches away from me. And over the years, my vision has improved. It is not perfect. It'll never be unless there is some, you know, operation out there that could fix me. But, you know, I'm okay with that because my vision makes me who I am. And, you know, different is beautiful. So I really, you know, I appreciate the fact that I have a vision impairment because sometimes taking a different approach on things and learning different ways to do things that are different from other people makes you a stronger person than everyone else. And I feel like, you know, strong That's people right. are awesome.
Well said. Boy,
what a great way to look at things. Well, this is your second appearance on our show. I hope you will come again.
Oh, well, like I said last time, we'll have to see when the bridge crosses or when the... Ah, I can't even say what I'm saying here. Ah!
When we cross that bridge?
When we'll cross that bridge when we get there. Back. Thank you. I couldn't even think of the words I wanted to say.
Kyla J., thank you so much for being here. Stand by. More of the Paul Santos Live Show. Straight ahead. Don't go anywhere.
Hold my hand. In other words, darling, kiss me. Fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, I love you.
How about the PSL band right there? These guys are awesome.
Thanks, Paul.
Hey, I was watching tonight. He's going to be a guest on the show in a few weeks. Mr. Butch Correa. Oh, yeah. Butch Correa is watching tonight. Deb Ramus is looking in tonight. And Robert Oliver out there in Australia. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
Is he on the Barbie?
Oh, yeah. He does an Australian accent, too. I forgot about that.
On the Barbie.
All right, time for our female perspective. Oh, our regular that. Diane Falafs. Here's Allison Diane.
Allison,
how are you? Thank you so much for being here tonight. How are you?
I'm wonderful. Happy birthday.
Thank you very much. It's nice for you to be here. You know, we were thinking about maybe should I take the night off, but I have so much fun doing the show, I figured, we'll just proceed along, you know?
Absolutely. Spend your birthday doing what you love.
That's right.
Did you know that Jennifer Lopez and you have the same birthday?
Oh, my God. Did you hear that, Chops? Me and J-Lo have the same birthday. Did you hear that,
wow.
Casey? Wow, that's pretty good.
Too bad you don't have the same butt.
Yeah. It turns out you two have a lot in common. You know, she's a singer, you're a singer. Yeah. She hosted a TV show, you host a TV show. She's a huge sex symbol, and you don't have as much in common as I thought.
Oh, that's right. I love this girl.
I thought I was just about to go 3 for 3 there for a second, Gary. wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, no, that's not going to happen. I love this girl. She's a welcome addition.
Birthday birthdays are tough. You know, my last birthday, I turned 40, and I had a midlife crisis. And my husband took that opportunity to brag to me that he never had a midlife crisis. I was like, honey, you are 20 years older than me. I am your midlife crisis.
Oh! Hey, watch out. Whoa.
Come on, how about a little bring over there? That deserves a bring.
I'm just so mesmerized by her. I can't even concentrate on anything else. She takes me off my mark.
I've gotten to the point where the numbers just keep accumulating. You know, that's what I'm worried about.
Well, I would ask you if you were having a midlife crisis right now, but in order for that to be the case, you'd have to have a life expectancy of about 120.
Oh!
Hey, watch out! Yeah!
Allison, thank you so much for stopping by. Well, thank you for booking all the comics. It's up to, because of her, she's been booking all the comedians. So that's why we got all the great comics like Sam Pelletier. So thanks a lot for all your help, and we'll see you soon. We'll see you next week.
Thank you, and happy birthday.
All right, we've got Boston's Queen of the Blues and Soul up next. Stay with us. It's the Paul Santos Live Show. Don't go anywhere. While we're setting things up for Tony Lynn Washington, I'd like to get a quick shout out to Deb Remus. Thank you very much for looking in tonight. And how about Roger Brightman, one of our regulars? Thank you very much looking in from home tonight. And thank you very much for your birthday wishes, Roger. Shout out to Bruce Sear. Thank you very much for the birthday wishes, Bruce. Stella Rich watching tonight. And from the NB Rude Boy, Sean Fitzgerald. Thank you very much.
Shawnee.
For wishing me a happy birthday, and for all the folks on social media, really appreciate it. All right. Miss Washington is coming on down. By the way, a little bit later on, we'll be hearing from Crazy Casey, and we'll be hearing from Isaac Resendiz, who's going to talk a little bit about a great Boston DJ, Mr. Skippy White, who's in the house tonight. Chops, how about that, Skippy White? He's a legendary big-time DJ, I'll tell you. Big party coming up for him in August. Yeah, he's got a big party coming up in August up in Boston, celebrating many, many years of entertainment. And of course, he's somebody that been on the radio and everything else. Gary Landsman, Artie DeMello, and the PSL Band. Let's hear it for those guys. All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would like to move on to our next guest. She came all the way down from Boston, Massachusetts, and we are so glad to have her here tonight. She came down to celebrate my birthday. She's going to mention a big show that's coming up soon. We are so, so thankful that she was down here in New Bedford, all the way down from Boston. Would you please welcome Boston's Queen of the Blues and Soul, Ms. Toni Lynn Washington!
Did you say I've got a lot to learn?
Well, don't think I'm trying not to learn. Since this is the perfect spot to learn. Teach me tonight. Starting with the ABC of it. Roll right down to the X, Y, and Z of it. Help me solve the mystery of it. Come on and teach me tonight. The sky is a blackboard high above us. If a shooting star goes by, I'll use that star to write I love you a thousand times across the sky. One thing is a very clear, my love. So the teacher stands so near, my love. Graduation's almost here, my love. Come on and teach me tonight. I'll use that star to write I love you 1,000 times across the sky. One thing isn't very clear, my love. So the teacher stands so near, my love. Graduation's almost here, my love. Come on, teach me tonight.
Oh my goodness, Tony Lynn Washington. Oh, thank you so much for being here again. It's so great to have you here, especially on my birthday. This is so exciting having you here.
Oh, happy birthday to you. My goodness, isn't he pretty? He's so good looking. Especially on his birthday, you know? Give him a round of applause.
Well, Ms. Washington, it's so great to have you here tonight. Boston's queen of the blues and soul. Tell us about that nickname, because that is really accurate. We love that name. And you actually changed this slightly, right?
Say what?
You changed it from Boston's queen of the blues, yes, to Boston's queen of the blues and soul.
Oh, yeah. I do a lot of blues, and I do a lot of soul. I do a lot of jazz. Mm. If I ever come back here again, I'm going to sing with you guys. Wow, you guys.
Is that a promise?
You sound great.
That's a promise. You're going to make a deal.
You sound awesome.
That's a deal.
Thank you. Thank you. See, I come from through a lot of eras of the music. I am 86 years old.
Amen, baby girl.
And I've been around the Rotary a few times. So I know what to do. And but I tell you, I'm a little nervous tonight because I'm not used to this new thing. What you call it, karaoke?
Yeah, you could do something like that, girl. Something like that. See, I was trying to put my finger, I couldn't put my finger on it, and that's exactly what it is. Miss Washington, you're a genius. Thank you. Thank you for... She nipped that right in the bud, baby.
All right.
Let's carry on.
I hope I did all right tonight.
Oh, you did great. You did great.
No. You did fantastic. As a matter of fact, we understand that you're going to be celebrating with the great Skippy White. Is that right? In August, right?
Yes.
Tell us about that event.
I'm going to be doing the Skippy White event.
Yeah, musical tribute.
Yeah, the musical tribute. Hi, Skippy.
Hey, Skippy White.
How you doing, baby?
Skippy!
That's Skippy White. Yeah, and we're going to have a ball, so if you guys have not got your ticket, get your $25 in your hand and give it to Isaac. Get your ticket and come on to the event. We're going to have a ball.
That's right. Give your money to Isaac. That's how it's going to work here tonight. Yeah, August the 5th, an evening with Skippy White, a musical tribute to a living legend, is going to be at Florian Hall, 55 Hallett Street in Boston. Once again, that is on August the 5th. So great job right there, and congratulations to Skippy White. Now, while we have you here making a trip down from Boston, we can't let you leave without doing another song. Can
yes,
we, Gary?
Yeah.
Oh, come on now. Definitely. How many people want to hear another song from Tony Washington,
yeah.
huh? You got something ready to go?
I'm ready to go. Do we have any Ray Charles fans in the audience tonight?
There she is. Tony Washington.
Right. All right now. Somebody say yeah. The blues is in the house. You know the nighttime is the right time. The right time, I said to be with the one you love. Yes, the night time is the right time. I said to be with the one you love. Well, my mother, she had to die. Oh, baby, you know I love you, and I'll place no one above you, because the night time, every day is the right time. I said to be with the one you love. I said, baby. Make everything all right. You know the night time. Every day's the right time. I had to be with the one you love. Make everything all right. You know the night time is the right time to be with the one you love. Oh, yeah.
All right, let's hear it once again for Boston's Queen of the Blues and Soul, Miss Toni Lynn Washington. Stand by, more of the Paul Santos Live Show coming up. Don't go anywhere. Sensational. Gotta love her, I'll tell ya. PSL band, ladies and gentlemen, those guys are awesome. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the time of the show where we're going to bring up the sidekick of the century, the co-host with Clash and Cachet. No Clash, no Cachet. Class, not Clash. Did I say Clash?
You did.
Nah, he's got a sensational voice, and we're always glad to hear from him. Ladies and gentlemen, world-class vocalist and entertainer, Chops Turner!
Chop it!
Hey, Chubbs, don't I look cute with the little stash, little sash on over here? You liking that?
Good, man.
All right?
The loveliness of Paris seems somehow sadly gay. The glory that was wrong is of another day. I've been suddenly alone to have and forgotten in New Bedford. I'm going home to my city by the bay. I left my heart in San Francisco, high on a hill, it calls to me to be where the two cable cars climb halfway to the stars. The morning fog may chill the air. Skippy, I don't care, my love waits there in San Francisco, above the blue and windy sea.
So much, Chops Turner, ladies and gentlemen. A big tribute to Tony Bennett, who he lost this past week into his 90s. What a real, real class gentleman and somebody who had such an impact on the music business. Tribute to Tony Bennett. Thank you very much, Chops Turner. Very nice, very nice. Well, I hate to do this, ladies and gentlemen, but I did promise last week, and I try to keep my promises. Would you please welcome Crazy Casey? Here he comes. You want to be on the other side, right? Okay, he always likes to be. He likes to have his good side, right?
No, I just like standing closer to Gary than I do to you. You know what? I was going to come out here, she comes Miss America. You look really good on that. I just read it. It does say birthday. Hey, I just want you to know that I did bring you a present. I looked for the gift table and there isn't any. But we planned a little. Hey, Chops, what do you think? Huh?
Yeah, I think we're ready. Yeah, I think we got that. We got that. Yeah.
Everybody sing whatever Gary plays.
Let's do another happy birthday all in the same key. Ready? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mother Mel. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, by the way, thank you so much for that.
Yeah, you got a gift too, huh? Well, by the way, Sam, great job. And I want you to know, I went to the Staples and I found out one thing. They do have Staples. This week, I'm going to Dick's.
The last resort, you mean?
Listen, Paul, I wanted you to have something from Usenix Manix that was grown by the residents there. They give the old people seeds and they mix them up, and this is what we get. Now, Usenix Manix is in a state forest in an undisclosed area, so people can put their people in a nursing home so nobody knows where they are. So here we go.
Is it okay if I open this right now?
It certainly is.
Thank you very much, Casey.
The big reveal.
I really appreciate it. Here we go. Let's see what's in here. I always enjoy opening presents.
I know you do.
Share it with the rest of us.
It's got pepperoni's disease.
Oh, look at that. That's a torta.
It's a torta.
That's a torta.
And I want you to tell you something. Could you put those glasses on before? You look like Pee Wee Herman.
Hey, thank you very much. Crazy Casey, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Oh, and by the way, I did want to thank Allison for the Portuguese wine. Thank you, Allison. Thank you very much. Hey, nothing like a little Portuguese moonshine. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to crack that open. Grace is going to come over. I'm going to put that away. I'll tell you right now. All right. Real quick, before we go, we're right up against the clock. But we'd like to bring up Isaac Resendiz, ladies and gentlemen, and Skippy White. Come on up. Come on up. Legendary Boston DJ. Come on over here. Skippy's going to come one on one side and one on the other. And as Skippy makes his way up here, what a great event you guys have lined up for August the 5th.
Absolutely. It's an absolute honor to be involved with this project. We are celebrating a legend, ladies and gentlemen.
Skippy White, come on over here this way. I'm going to stand in between you. One on one side and one on the other. How's that? All right. So Skippy over here and Isaac over here. Skippy, I know you've been in the DJ business for a while, and to be able to celebrate with you.
63 years.
Oh, you started the year I was born.
Yeah, that's right.
But it makes me feel a little better.
All right.
Well, that's great. I mean, all those years of being a legendary DJ and all that, what have you loved about it the most?
Oh, I love the music. Right. Yeah, I mean, I really specialize in rhythm and blues, and that's what I've played my whole career.
Well, speaking of rhythm and blues, how about Tony Lynn Washington?
Oh, what a talent, huh? Yeah.
So why is it important to honor this man right here?
Well, after 63 years of service to the community, I think it's about time that we pay him a thank you for all of his years and dedication to the city of Boston and music in general.
Fantastic. That's going to be a big night. Yeah. Looking forward to that, I'm sure.
Oh, absolutely. I'm excited about it. I'm really excited. It's going to be a great night.
You have that, like, DJ voice, you know?
Well, we try. Been doing it for a while.
And you introduced like those doo-wop groups and stuff like that?
Oh, yeah. Doo-wop was my thing.
I know. Huh?
I started with doo-wop.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm telling you, the DJ.
Yeah.
Hey, well, Skippy, it's always great to see you. Thanks for taking the trip down from Boston to hang out with us here in New Bedford. And it's great to have you here on my birthday. That makes it even more special.
Absolutely. Happy birthday to Paul Santos again. Can we give it a round for Paul Santos?
Hey, Paul.
One last thing. If you're interested in coming to the event, it's at 55 Hallett Street in Dorchester at the Florian Hall, Saturday, August the 5th. And we just ask everyone to come out. You call 857-212-2737 or contact at startimeentertainment.com.
All right. Isaac Resendiz, thank you so much. Skippy, thank you for being here.
All right. Thank you, Paul.
All right. Grab a seat right over there. Thank you so much for being here. All right. All right. There it goes, Skippy White. All right. So, Chops, you know, I was just thinking, we're winding down the show over here. And look over here. You want to have a little taste of this?
Mm. Can I have some?
How about this right here?
I'm all good with that. You can have all that, brother. You can have all that. That's all for you, bro.
Casey got one for himself.
That's all you. That's all you.
I already said he already has one.
Watch out.
All right, and now we got somebody's here tonight. Real quick round of applause. The drummer from the Berklee College of Music, played many years with the great Grammy group, Tavares. Jackie Santos is here tonight. Yeah. Ah, yes. And how about Juicy Brucey's in the house, baby? That's what I'm talking about. Juicy Brucey. And how about Grace and Nate Case, our favorite fans? There you go. Come on, Grace. I'll give you a shaking head. You want to take a bow? Come on. Come on, take a bow. Take a bow, Grace. Come on, take a bow. And how about our good friend Nancy Andrade right over there? We love her. I was going to give her an adjective, but I decided not to do that tonight. Hey, we'd like to take our opportunity to thank our guests. How about Kyla J? Thank you for coming tonight. Boston's Queen of the Blues and Soul, Tony Lynn Washington. Legendary DJ Skippy White. Fantastic comic Sam Pelletier. For Dying for Laughs, it's Allison Dying. Skippy White, the Boston legendary DJ, if I skipped him. And of course, our good friend, we love him, Crazy Casey, that's right, we kind of love him. Hey, I'm Paul Santos, thank you very much for being with us tonight. And we'll see you next week where we have from a really, really great group, Hardwire Rock. Paul Condies is going to be here and his wife, that'll be great. And we also have Rowan and Beautiful Human are going to be here as well, another great group. So again, I'm Paul Santos. Thanks for watching tonight. Don't forget to laugh and have a great night, everybody.
'Cause it's sweet, sweet and clear as moonlight through the pines.
Thank you.
Reach out to me, girl. Oh, the eyes smile tenderly. Still and peaceful dreams I see. The road I said it leads back to you. Georgia, I saw you, oh, yeah, coming on sweet song, yeah, keeps Georgia forever on my mind.